Hello everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video I'm going to show you everything that you need to know to get up and running with Instagram. As you probably know, Instagram is one of the world's most popular social platforms right now, and in this video I'm going to touch upon every feature that Instagram offers, so I do recommend that you follow along with your own Instagram account, and do remember to pause and rewind the video as necessary. There will also be a table of contents to this video in the description of this video here on YouTube. So to get started with Instagram, you do need the Instagram app and you need an Instagram account. So whether you're using an iPhone, an Android device, you need to go to your App Store. So on an Android device, that would be the Google Play Store. And then when you're in the Google Play Store, go ahead and just search for Instagram. And then go ahead and download and install the Instagram app. If you need to run any updates, it's a good time to do that as well. Once the Instagram app has been installed and updated, go ahead and open up the app. Now, if you already have an Instagram account, you can go ahead and log in with that account. If you don't yet have an Instagram account, go ahead and create one. You'll notice that there is a sign up button on this screen on my phone. But I do have some Instagram accounts that I'm going to be using for this video, so I'm just going to log into those accounts. I have a brand new account that I just created that we're going to take a look at so that my account looks very similar to what yours might look like if you're just creating a new account. And then I also have an account that I've used quite a bit that we'll also take a look at. So I'm just going to log in now. What we're going to do is we're going to go over the Instagram user interface a little bit. We're going to see where everything's located. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to put our profile together a little bit. We'll add a profile picture, a little bit of a description. We'll upload our first photo, and we'll talk about how we can view other people's photos on Instagram and interact with other Instagram users. The primary way to navigate within Instagram is by using the buttons at the bottom of the screen. So you can see that when we first log into our account, we're on the home feed. And we can tell that because the button on the bottom of our screen with the house icon is filled in black. This is where we'll see photos from people that we follow on Instagram as they upload them. So this is kind of like your news feed, your feed on Facebook, your feed on Twitter. This is where you see the uploads that other people are posting to Instagram. Now the next button over on the bottom is the search button. And by tapping on that button, we're able to browse other posts on Instagram. So right now we're just looking at some of the most popular posts. So we could scroll through all of these photos. And then if we find a photo that we like, so for example this one, we could tap on it and we'll open up the photo. And on this screen, we can see who's posted the photo, and then we can see some information regarding the post. So we can see that this photo was posted by clo.photo. So we could actually tap on the profile name up at the top, and it would take us to this person's profile. So they're a photographer. We could then scroll through their profile to see some more of their posts. We could also follow this user if we wanted to by clicking on the blue follow button. We can see that this user's posted 840 posts, has 104,000 followers, and is following 636 people. If we wanted to send this user a message, we could tap on the message button, or we could tap on the email button to send them an email. Now, the reason that this user has those options is because they've configured their Instagram account as a business account, because they're a photographer and they're promoting their photography. I will show you later on in this video how you can configure your Instagram account as a business account, which essentially allows you to add these buttons for easier access to communicate with you so people can just tap to email you. It also allows you to advertise on Instagram at some point in the future if you'd like to. And it gives you access to enhanced Instagram analytics so you can see which of your Instagram posts are most popular. But you can see this is a pretty good looking profile, and then we could of course scroll down and we could tap on other pictures by this user to see information about those specific photos. However, let's go ahead and let's tap on the back button at the top left for now. When we were looking at this photo, we decided to tap to access the profile, but there are a few more ways that we could have interacted with this photo. First of all, we can see that this user added a location for this photo, so we can see it was taken at Moraine Lake Lodge. We could tap on that location if we wanted to see more photos from that location. Down towards the bottom of the photo, we have the option to heart the photo, so we could tap on the heart icon to give it a like, or alternatively, you could just double tap right on the photo, and you'll notice that it also likes the photo. We could tap on the chat bubble to add a comment, so you'll notice that we could add a comment to the bottom, kind of your standard commenting options. You can add emojis if you'd like, and you can also at mention users, so just like on Twitter. And then if we wanted to add this post to our Instagram story, we could tap on the arrow icon, and you'll notice that we have the option to add it to our story, or we could also send this as a message to another user. So saying, hey, I found this post and I thought you'd enjoy it, you should take a look. That's how you can send that to another user. Then you'll notice that on the right side of this photo at the bottom, we have a little bookmarking option. So we could tap to save this photo to our collection so we could easily access it later on. And if we scroll down a little bit more, you'll notice that the uploader of this photo posted a comment, a little bit of a description to the photo down below. And then they've added a whole bunch of hashtags, so you can see how hashtags are used on Instagram like they're used on Twitter and other social networks. If I wanted to see some more photos that were related to some of these hashtags, I could tap on one of these hashtags and it would take me to more photos where the uploaders have used these hashtags. So if you're looking to use Instagram for business or for promoting something, definitely make use of hashtags. They can really increase the amount of people that your photos are able to reach. Okay, so I'm going to tap back now. Remember, we were on the search screen and we just tapped on one of the photos that we found here. So these are just popular photos, but if we had tapped in the actual search bar, you'll notice that we can type to start searching here in Instagram. So we could search for users, we could search for topics, we could search for accounts, places. So for instance, you could search for Los Angeles, right? And now if we wanted to look specifically for places, instead of searching in this top section, this top is just showing us the most popular results, no matter what type of result they are, we could tap on the Places tab, and this would only take us to top places that start with Lausanne. We could go to tags, and you can see that Los Angeles is a popular tag. So you can really search for anything that you are looking for here on Instagram, and then you can start to follow people who have similar interests or who are posting photos that you enjoy. So you could go to the account section and you could say, hey, here's the Lakers account. So I like those photos. So you could tap to follow the Lakers account. And now if we go to our home feed again and we refresh, you'll notice that I'm starting to see Lakers photos come in here and I'm at the home section. Because now that I follow the Lakers, I'm seeing their photos in my home section. The third button over on the bottom of the screen is the upload photo button. So we could tap on the upload button, which looks like a plus symbol, and then it will show us recent photos that we have on our device, and we can start to upload these photos to Instagram. So first of all, we can crop the photo on this first screen here. So I'm just using my two fingers to zoom in and out because this was actually a screenshot. So I want to zoom in a little bit so I don't have any of the other information on there. So let's say I like the photo as is from right there. I can now tap the next button at the top right, but notice that at the bottom of your screen, I'm looking at the gallery section on my phone, but you have some other sections you could access depending on your device. So you could go to the photo section, or I could look for videos as well, because you can upload videos to Instagram just like you can photos. But I like this photo right here, so I'm just going to tap next in the top right. And now I can use the Instagram filters. So if I take a look at the bottom of my screen, I have a number of pre-made filters that I can use. These are filters that were already created by Instagram. So as I tap, I can see my photo change to the top, and I can see how it's going to look. It's kind of like a preview of what it's going to look like when I use one of these filters. Now at the same time, if I want to be a little bit more creative and not just use a pre-made filter from Instagram, I can tap on the edit button at the bottom, and this will give me access to specifically edit all the different features of this photo. So for instance, I could tap on the brightness section, and then from here I could increase the brightness or I could decrease the brightness, then tap done. I could go to contrast and I could change that. So I can go in here to every individual area of this photo and I can modify it to my liking. So this is a great way to go a little bit beyond the Instagram filters and just, you know, use your own creativity to edit the photo however you'd like. I'm not as creative as some of you probably are, however, so I'm actually just going to use a pre-made filter for this. So I like, you know, the Clarendon filter is pretty good. So now I'll go ahead and I'll tap next. On the next screen, we have the option to fill out any information that we'd like to add to this post. So we can add a caption if we'd like, and this is where we can add any hashtags as well. So I could just say my workspace for the day, and then I could add any hashtags. We'll just enter, say, working. But you'll notice that when I start adding a hashtag, so typing the pound symbol and then starting my term, a list of popular hashtags appear. So if this post fits one of the hashtags I see in the list, I could just tap to add it. And you can add up to, I'm not sure if there even is a limit. There used to be a limit on Instagram, but you can add a lot of hashtags to each post, so you shouldn't run out of room. If there were people in this photo that you wanted to tag, you could tap in the Tag People section, and then you could tap on the post to tag any people. If you wanted to add your location, you could also do that. And then if you've connected any other accounts to your Instagram account, say Facebook, Twitter, or Tumblr, you could also post this photo to those accounts as well. However, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to post this to Instagram, so I'll go ahead and I'll tap on the Share button at the top right. And there's my post. So you can see we've uploaded our first post to Instagram. Okay, so that's how you can upload a regular post Notice that at the top of my home screen here, if I wanted to add a post to my story, I could do so by tapping on the plus icon next to your story. And this is where I could record a video to add to my Instagram story. Remember, stories on Instagram, if you don't know, only last 24 hours. You will be able to access them later on if you want to look at them, but other people won't see things that you post that were older than 24 hours ago if you post it to your story. So it's kind of a cool way to post things that are in the moment. A lot of people get really creative with stories, so I recommend that as you use Instagram, you look at other people's Instagram stories to kind of get ideas on what you can do with your stories. But do know that it is a little bit different than posting a regular photo. So to post a regular photo, we're clicking on the plus symbol at the bottom. To post a story, we're either clicking on the plus symbol right here from the home feed, or I'll also show you how we can post stories from our profile section. But before we go to our profile section, I am going to tap on this heart symbol at the very bottom because we haven't looked at this section yet. And this is the activity section of Instagram. This is where we get notifications when somebody likes or comments on our posts. We get all that information in here. So whether we're using Instagram just for personal use or as a business, this is a great way to interact with other people on Instagram. We can see people who are liking our photos and the content that we're uploading, and then we can maybe respond to them or take a look at their profiles as well. And then the final tab on the bottom of the Instagram app is the profile tab. So this is where we can access our own profile. And you'll notice that from this screen, we don't really have much yet. We do have the one photo that we uploaded, but we don't have a profile photo. We don't have any information about ourselves. So to add information to our Instagram profile, we can just tap on the Edit Profile button. Now from here, we could add our name if we wanted to. We can tap on the Change Profile Photo button to actually change the profile photo that we're showing here on Instagram. We could add a website to our profile if we wanted to, a little bit of a biography, or you'll also notice that from here, we can switch to a professional account. So that is the business account that I spoke about earlier on in the video. So if you wanted to have access to advertising features, to some more enhanced analytics, and to be able to put a contact button on your profile, you're going to want to switch your account over to a professional account. And when I show you my other account here again in a few minutes, you might see the difference because that account is a professional account, and I'll show you where the analytics option is on Instagram once you've switched your personal Instagram profile over to a professional account. But for now, I'm just going to tap on the X button. I think you can add this information on your own, and you'll be able to see in my other Instagram profile what it looks like once I've added all that information. So I do want to show you, before we move to that other account, another area that we can access here on Instagram is at the very top right. You'll notice that there's these three little lines. If you tap on that, you have access to some more areas within Instagram. And the one that I'm most interested in showing you is the area at the bottom, and that is the settings area. So if we tap on settings, we have access to all of the different Instagram settings. And this is another area where I think you can look through on your own time and find the settings that are most pertinent to you. But there are a couple of places that I think are most important. So first of all, if you tap on the privacy section, there are a lot of different options in here regarding privacy for people commenting on you, for the tags that you see on Instagram. You can block accounts, you can mute accounts. So if at any point you want to change your privacy settings in Instagram, this is where you can do that. You'll notice that in the connection setting where it says account privacy, by default, Instagram accounts are public. So everybody can see your photos, but this is where you could turn your account to be a private Instagram account. You would just tap to switch on the private account feature. I'm not going to do that for now, however. I think it's also important to note that if we go back out of this privacy section here in settings, you can also modify your notifications here on Instagram. So that's notifications when people are commenting on your posts or liking your posts or following your Instagram account. So I did want to show you how you can access your settings here on Instagram, but now let's go ahead and let's move over to my other Instagram account. So to do that, I'm just going to tap on my account name at the top left. You'll notice that I have access to my other account. It's the antsandalex.com account. Go ahead and follow me if you don't already. You'll notice that you can see what the account looks like when it's been fully configured and all of my profile information has been added. So I have some hashtags and information on my biography, including a link to my YouTube channel. And then I have some photos down below that you can see. And because this is a professional account, if I tap on the three little lines at the top right, you'll notice that I have a few other areas within my Instagram account. And the one that I wanted to show you most importantly is the Insights section. So if we tap on Insights, I haven't been using this Instagram account very much lately, but we will get information on how many people are viewing our account, how many new followers we're getting, how many people were reaching with the posts that we're uploading to Instagram. So if you're using Instagram for marketing or for business use, this is a great place to go to find out which posts have been most successful for you and which ones you could maybe improve upon a little bit. So I hope that after watching this video, you're now able to come into Instagram to set up your profile, get a profile picture, start posting, and then go to the search section and find some users to follow on Instagram. You can see what they're doing, and you can really be as creative as you want with Instagram. It's a great platform to network and to just show everybody what you're doing. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.